Hello everyone, welcome back to the awesome Titanic solution series. In the previous video, we built a decision tree with selected variables and it did not give us a better score than we expected, right? So for example, here with the selected variables and the decision tree model with grid search, we're able to get 0.77990, which is not an improvement if we used all the features within decision tree along with grid search, right? So let's explore another model that is called the extra tree classifier. Now there are two different types of model and I'm just going to show you both of these methods so that you don't get confused, right? So within the sklearn.tree we have an extra tree classifier, and there is also another version called as the sklearn ensemble extra trees classifier. Now both of these methods are different. Extra trees classifier falls under the ensemble modeling techniques, whereas the extra tree classifier falls under the sklearn tree package, right? So obviously we're going to use this one as we are in decision trees and then sort of move on to other models on ensemble later on, right? Obviously in the previous version, what we did is selected 15 variables and then built a model, right? So in this particular method, what we're going to do is use the same selection process of variables and then use an extra tree classifier to build a model and see if we can get an improvement of score. So what I'm going to do is import pandas as PD, import the train data set, test data set, and then do our X and Y as we usually do. Now the feature selection method is going to remain same. I'm going to use the SelectKBest method, right, and the chi square score, right? So this will help me basically select the best variables. Now within this, I'm not going to run the x.head, not required anymore since we've already seen it a lot of times. This time I'm going to select 30 features using the SelectKBest method with the score of chi square, right? So let's see what happens there, and then I basically get the top 30 features that I need for building this model. Now if I move down and then do the train test split, and this time import the extra tree classifier versus the decision tree classifier that we earlier had, right? Now once we do that, we can run a model and see if we can get a score, default model, right? So the default model is not, you know, obviously not going to be that big of a deal, but let's see if we can do a grid search CV method and see the best combinations that we can get, right? So I'm going to run it, and this time I've just increased the max depth to, let's say, 20. Probably that will help us to know if there is any better, you know, algorithm or better combination that can be run, right? So these are the parameters for hyper tuning, and then I do a grid search CV on the extra tree classifier, get my parameters and see what's the best score that we can get. Now there is some warning which I can ignore for now, and let's see the best estimator, right? So with this, what we're getting is max step 12, and what I can do is select this features that I have, that have the parameters that I have, and paste it here, right? So if I run this and see the score, it's 0.8250, and then build the best model that we could, fit the model, right, and see the score, right? So obviously the training score is around 0.90. That is a little different from what we have there. It's probably because we didn't set the random state, but that's okay for now since we are exploring. And then we get the best features as well, right? But I'm just going to move on to the next part where we are going to see the test and train score, where I basically take all the selected variables that we have from there and see the shape. That's 268 by 30, which is basically our test set, right? And then predict it on the selected test set and see what's the scope what we have from there, right? So if you can see, you know, the training set is obviously slightly overfitted and the test set is performing very bad, right? So obviously we can already guess that this particular model is not going to do better than the decision tree there, right? So what I did is I basically ran all this code and then uploaded it to Kaggle, and I got a score of 0.76, right? So with 30 with 30 variables, I got 0.76. And I also, you know, imported another version with 15 variables, and you can see the score is not that better, right? So it's 0.77 and 0.76, both of which are not an improvement over the log model that we built. Obviously, we're going to keep exploring and see if we can improve the score by using different modeling techniques, right? So in the next video, what we'll do is explore an ensemble modeling called as a random forest and see if we can get a good mix, good balance of test and train scores using random forest method. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please do not forget to hit the like button, and please do not forget to subscribe to my channel.